Alright guys, welcome back to another Enderman LP video here on the Ender LP Vanilla server. So, yep, it's another episode today, and there's a bunch of cool stuff that we're gonna do. So, you guys saw that radiation symbol last episode. I think that's still pretty cool, and we're gonna go take a look at it on our map, because that looks pretty awesome. And we're also going to be adding some stuff. Speaking of maps, I have a bunch of maps over here, and I've been going around in a boat and mapping out the rest of our area here. We just have a couple more maps left around the edges, and we're gonna put those in. So you can see we are right over there, little green dot. So let's start off, do the honors with the first map. Right over there, and second map, the next one over here, filling in all of the last spaces around the edge. This took about an hour to go all the way around this, but we're finally going to have a complete map, and it's going to look very awesome. So I just need to make sure that they're in the right order, so that they match up properly. I can't remember if I got any out of order. I tried to keep them one after the other, so that it's easier to place. Yep, that looks all good. That one matches as well. There we go. Gotta get up a little higher over here. Very nice. These two, and that one must go there, and that one over there, and a bit higher up here. Let's see, yes, that's correct, and very nice. A couple more maps in this chest that we gotta get, and we're gonna have a very nice looking map wall over here. So I think, is this the right one? No, I think this is the same one as that one. I must have made a double. So let's throw that out right now. And I think this one goes there, very nice. And yes, correct, all right. So this one over here is a double, so we don't need that. Accidentally misclicked while I was going around. And one at the top there, can't reach it. There you go. Very nice. And I think the ones in my inventory start later. There's still more over here. Yes, there is. It's gonna take a while to put all these maps in, but it's gonna look awesome. Totally worth all the time to go do this. And now how do I get up there? Dang it. Just pull her up over here a second time. And while I'm putting these maps, in case you haven't noticed, I am now recording in 1080p. It will just take longer to upload, but I think I'm gonna start just doing it uploading during the night, so that it doesn't really bother me while I'm using the internet during the day, and that way you guys can get some better quality. I might also record using the NVIDIA Shadow Play, which was, I think, the last one or two videos I recorded and uploaded were using Shadow Play, and that works pretty well. But you can't record windows, so you have to record full screen. And I'm not used to playing Minecraft full screen. I usually do it in a maximized window. So, I might try it. I don't know if it's going to be really noticeable. But we'll see. So, there we go. Whoops. I think I messed that up. Let's put in... I think... to the ones in my inventory start now. No, not yet. I think there's one more, I guess. Let's go check. No, two more. Okay. So, that's it. We don't have to go down here anymore. Great. So, yeah. Alright, let's go back up here. I also set the audio settings on Bandicam now to record audio at 386 kilobits per second, and I don't know if that really makes a difference, because my mic is not that good, but yeah, try it anyways, and we'll see how big the files get. Alright, got just a couple more maps over here, and we're going to be finished. There's a snow biome up there. Seems like I did a pretty good job of keeping everything in order. And last row of maps. Whoops. Can I not go? Doesn't want to go in. Alright. We'll just go back down again. And do it from there. Alright. Okay. So, what other stuff are we going to do this episode? I have a plan to remake the redstone of the piston door in the nether. Because currently it's a 2x2 door. So, too high, too wide. But I find that it's kind of claustrophobic there, because it's not very spacious. It's just a small tunnel. See, that's a lava pool over there. Looks very red. And so we're going to try to remake that, do a little redstone today, and we're going to make a big, very large 2x3 door, so same size as a nether portal. And I think that's going to look a lot better over there. But here we go. Last two maps, and ta-da, it is finished. You can see these maps are a bit different colors due to the lighting over here, but this is just temporary lighting, so we'll have more even lighting in the future. But there we go, that is the finished map. Obviously I'll be adding more in the future to, like, bottom over here. Got one more row of space, there's a couple more rows at the top, and a bunch more space on the side, but I think at the moment we're going to keep it like this, because it does cause quite a bit of lag. You can see it's around 30 frames per second just looking at 300 maps over here. So yeah, I think that's going to stay like this until we get some sort of FPS improvement with item frames. But it still looks pretty good. So we've got, I think it's a 12 by 12. Yeah, 12 wide, 12 high row of maps. So that's 144 maps over here. The 300 is because I've got a couple hundred more item frames in my storage room over there. But yeah, this is the map. And looks pretty awesome, I have to say. Let's see if we can go up over here. Very nice. Looks great. You can see our base over here. I don't like this thing. That used to be a jungle temple, and I tore it down because it was solid sandstone. Jungle temples are made out of sandstone, and they go all the way down, like, 10 blocks deep or something. So I was able to get like half a double chest of sandstone out of just mining that out. But the sad thing is that sandstone appears gray, like stone, on maps. And there's also a bunch of stone over there, and then there's also some dirt. So I have to say that doesn't look that good, and I'll probably cover it up with sand sometime in the future. This place over here, that is our slime farm, and that one is just stone on top, so I'm not sure what I'm going to do about that. because it doesn't look too great. But yeah, overall, this place is looking pretty cool. Plain gray for those two, got the radiation sign, and those are the farms. Those are eventually going to be covered up. I was working on covering that up with some smooth stone this episode as well. But anyways, there we go. We got our map finished. And I also wanted to show you guys in single player. I actually have over here, where is it? There is, well, this is the prototype of the door I'm working on. So this is what I want to build in the Nether. Obviously working with the hidden things, so it's 2x3 instead of just 2x2. That will give us more room. And this is the biohazard sign we are going to build on top of one of our circles over there at our base. And yeah, I basically got it from an image and then converted it into Minecraft and then pasted it in MC Edit. But the thing is, it's the wrong size, and this thing over here is actually a bit larger than a 64 block radius circle. So I'm going to have to do some stuff with images and try to make this a little smaller so we can actually fit it. But yeah, that's all I wanted to show you guys. And now I'm going to go get some supplies and we're going to work on the new door in the Nether. Alright guys, all ready to do some redstone. So let's go to the Nether. And I got my redstoning supplies here, as well as a couple building blocks, which we're going to need to use. It's a pretty simple redstone, nothing too special. Yeah, this stuff needs to be changed a little. So, let's go outside. Alright. I do not want to be working around with these guys here. So, let's get rid of them. There we go, got rid of three, and there we go. Alright. So, right now, over back here, can we break in through here? Yes, we can. We got the trap chests here, which send the signal. And, they both do that, so you can actually click on anywhere over here. You can see the two blocks are not lighting up. So those are the two bent stairs that we're using to hiding that. And you open the chest, sends a signal, and then that goes underneath, hits some little blocks, and goes to our door over here. So we're gonna need to extend this. I'm gonna have to see how much space we have though, because we're right at the top of the Nether here. So we might hit some bedrock up above. But we'll try it, see how it goes. There we go. It's a big mess of redstone. Okay, let's see. So in my design, had two blocks. This is going to need to go back one more. Gonna need a little more room over here. So let me just make some space over here and get some stuff ready. Okay, there we go. So we got a little more room over here. First thing we're gonna do is remove this redstone that's coming up. Take this down, put some netherrack, and we're gonna need to put, cobblestone over here, two blocks on top of these redstone torches, which I don't think I will be able to reach. There we go. Okay, and behind this we're gonna need to put two repeaters to power those. Let's get rid of this quartz over here. Power that stuff, and we're also going to need to go underneath and unpower the two pistons over here, and I have no idea how I wired this, but it's a huge mess. And does that do something? Hopefully it does. I think that's it. You got the two pistons retracted now, or four pistons. And you have to add some pistons up here, up over there, and up over here as well. Okay, now on top of this, gotta remove that. Let's put those two blocks there again. And do a little bit of redstone. Let's fix this up here. Now we need our four blocks. And two repeaters. Very nice. So now whenever we power on these two repeaters here, it should retract all of these six pistons over there. Very nice. And same for this side. Let's put some redstone down. Okay. Now, the difficult part is actually getting power to these two top two pistons. And, well, actually all six of these pistons from the top and the bottom. Because we can't have anything over here on the side. So, I used to use this cable going up to those blocks underneath. We're going to change that up. And, we're going to use some torches powering those blocks from underneath. Let's see. Let's remove that. Get our cobblestone. Okay, and we need to put two torches on that. Very nice, and now I need to find a way out. Alright, let's go see. Did that do all two pistons? Okay, and we gotta get the last top two from the back over here. So can I actually go up a little higher? Yeah, that's nice. We'll just mine all this out and make some room to build around here. It's very, very cramped space. Oh, bedrock in the way. And, yeah, okay, I think that's good. Yeah, so these two pistons need to be powered from above using some redstone wire. And, when this gets powered, should do all of those four pistons, and now we have a total of six. Very nice. I think we can actually put the chiseled quartz here already, and that's what it's gonna look like. Alright. Next thing we gotta do is wire that up to this redstone torch over here. So that's powering this block over there. And we can draw power off from here, like that, and power. Alright, so that should be, that part is done. Now we also need to wire up this cable to the bottom two over here. And from what I can see, signal comes from this place. So, this is not the best pulse extender. I'm gonna have to think about my redstone over here. I'll come back when I have it figured out what I actually did over here, because I do not understand what I did. Okay, so basically all this thing was just a pulse extender, but I think I'm gonna redo this part. So let's go back down here. We got these two torches that need to be powered by this redstone line here, or unpowered, I should say. So what we're gonna do is put a couple repeaters over here. One there and there. And then these are going to take power from this line of redstone. We've also got another line going down beneath here. And that's going to be the one that opens the other side. So let's set that to 0 for now. And let's see. So let's try pressing the button, see what happens. Okay. That is not what was supposed to happen, obviously, but it's not finished. Let's try it. Okay, so side works. These retract very nicely, except they are not timed correctly. So let's go count the delays over here. So we got one tick of delay on that one, and here we have two ticks of delay. So we should add a repeater here to make it look all good and proper. So let's see. Repeater needs to go there, and put a couple blocks back. All right, let's test it out now. Was over here. Okay, so it seems like these need to retract a bit later, so we can add a bit of delay on the repeater that is over there. Let's try it with one, because we want the door to open as fast as possible, but not so we don't waste any time. Nope, that was still too fast. Try that one more time. And let's see. Aha! Perfect, that's exactly what we want to happen. All we have to do now is just wire up this side, and we should be done. So, this is the one that goes to that side over there. It's got two ticks of delay. So we need to send one to this side with two ticks of delay, and we are going to use this method. We have a wire running up this cobblestone, and we do not want that connecting, so let's roll over that one more. And we need, I think that was three ticks, yeah. And we're gonna put redstone line there, and let's test it out now. Both sides wired up. Aha! Very nice, there we go. Finally got it. One thing I miscalculated over here, this is gonna be visible when the door opens, and we don't want to be able to see any cobblestone on the ceiling here. So we're going to need to change that out with something that looks better. And we're going to use... what do we have on the floor there? I can't see. Got chiseled quartz. Let's make a bit more chiseled quartz over here. And like that. Alright, so we're going to put that on the ceiling over here. And I think I need to make a bit more. Yeah. Okay. There we go. And we're gonna replace these pieces of cobblestone. Whoops. I'm getting stuck. Two chisel quartz and place a redstone on top of that. Very nice. Now when we open this, chisel quartz top and bottom. Alright, there we go. Let's place this around the sides here, make that look nice. And I also want to fill up all of these unnecessary spaces that we dug out for doing the redstone. fill that back in. And also on the side, there's a bunch of empty space. So let's do that. Don't want to cut off that wire. And alright, I think that's good. So, we're almost finished here. One last thing I need to change is this pulse extender here. I'm going to make it a pulse extender. Right now it's just a bunch of repeaters. So, I'm going to have repeater, block. And we're going to need to extend this out this way. Whoa, big cave. Do not want that. There we go. Got some stuff. And block it off. Alright. Whoops. So we're going to put a repeater over here. And yeah, I think one more block's fine. We'll check how much delay this is afterwards. We need to have remove all this just a waste of space. These two wires need to be connected. And fill that in. Alright, I'm just going to finish this pulse extender and we'll see when it's finished. Alright guys, so that took a while. I finally got it working. So here's the pulse extender I made, very simple. Just a couple of repeaters, and then we got signal coming up from here or from here. And then this goes to the two sides. And then this one goes down to the bottom and to the top. So it's fully working now. And there we go. You can easily go out. It shuts behind you. And very nice. Closes very quickly too. And now the last things that we gotta do is just make this look pretty around here. Fill in all of the empty spaces. I'm just gonna leave that open for now. But wanna cover most of this stuff up and make it look all nice. These lamps are gonna have to go up one block. And will that be possible with this here? Yes, I think it is. Just have to put the lever there, and ta-da, there we go, very nice. Let's move this another rack here too. Very, very nice, I like that. Got more room up here, and yeah, looking pretty good. Still a bunch of empty spaces around here that, can take care of just like that. Okay, and also fill in all of this over here. Okay, and let's cover this up. Very nice. Whoopsies. And let's go inside and do the last part, which is put back all the quartz that I took away and remake the wall. There we go. Very nice. And I think last place over here. This cobblestone. It's just a solid cobblestone over here. It's actually because when you get out of minecarts, you used to go over to like three blocks away or something. Always put you back here. So I changed that, and I think that's been fixed, but I'm just going to keep that cobblestone there anyways. Cover that up, and there we go, it's finished. We got a 3-block tall doorway, secretly activated. Very nice. Really like this place, looking better and better. Put a couple more ladders here. This goes to the top of the nether, yeah, and we can replace this cobblestone here with the smooth sandstone, and yeah, nothing here yet, but Yeah. Alright. There we go. Now it matches the bottom here, since this place is 3 high, now the top is 3 high as well. Very cool. And, I don't know, I might put some paintings here or something. Little decoration, since it's kind of plain. But, yeah, that's going to be it for this episode. We got quite a bit done. I think I was going to say one more thing, which I forgot about. I don't know. I guess I'll remember for next episode. Thank you guys for watching. And, oh yes, I just remembered. Very close to the 2K sub special. So, be sure to like and subscribe to get there sooner. I've got some pretty sweet stuff planned. And, yeah, I'm pretty sure you guys are all gonna like it. So, thanks for watching again. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.